And welcome back to more Digimon Story, Cyber Sleuth. Last time, remember, we cleared another story. Which I'm pretty sure, at this point in time, it needed to be done. So, apparently your friend's moping around the K Cafe again. I suppose it's a tough age. I guess what I should do is I want to sell mementos. Three HP capsules. SP capsules. What is it this time, man? Yeah. What to do? Hey. Oh, Takumi! How long have you been there? I just came in. Looks like your many years of experience as a detective has made you a master of sleuth. No, I just came in the door. No, that can't be right. What's going on? What am I worried about? Damn it, how could you tell? You're too good at the detective stuff. I'm just looking at you and you look like you're frazzled, son. What's wrong? Well, maybe it's better to ask you about this. Anyway, doesn't seem like I'm going to solve this one on my own. Uh-huh. I see, I gotta go and check it out. Flowers for Sakura. No, what should I do? What can I do? Is there something I can give to win over over a girl's heart? Besides being yourself? Investigation start! Your girlfriend will be getting out of the hospital soon and you want to give her a present. I can't go keep your first little bit to second to you. Not yet. What on earth does that mean? Look, if you want to give her a present, just give her whatever you want.
True.
I'd like to get something a girl would like. Could you help me choose something? But you know you'll have to pay for this if it's an official case, right? If that's okay. I just want her to have the best possible present. But I mean, she's just getting out of the hospital, that's all. Don't you think you're all taking this a bit too far? Just give it a rest already! I know you're a detective and all, but stop constantly analyzing every little thing for once! Because I really mind not to take on a case unless I completely understand it. Same with Let's Plays! Okay, I suppose I can make an exception just for now. Just for now? That sounds scary. I need money in order to buy the present, so I'll get a part-time job. I heard some good haunted spots outside of Eden, but I still need your help. Still working in ghost photography. I guess that's fine, so we're looking for something to grow with my kid. Sorry, but I stopped thinking like a girl a long time ago, and you're too worldly. So that leaves us with a bit of a problem. In this situation, I should say you should ask your feminine friends.
Ask women?
Your feminine friends. Perfect! She's probably not really that kind of person, but at least she will try her best, or at least how she seems to me. I think she's in Shinjuku right now. Go ask her on her opinion on girl's presents.
Present to get the girl as a keyword. Seriously! That's all I gotta say, like, the fuck?
You mean to tell me I gotta go?
The things I do for love.
You desperately need to ask me.
Leota's asking because she wants to give someone a present, so that's a good present.
Huh? You're looking for a present for a girl? Do you have any more information than that? A girl's present. Talk to me. Why are you asking me about this?
Because you're a girl.
Oh my god, you like someone, don't you?
What?
What? You already have me. But since you couldn't have me all to yourself, you need to find someone else to come with.
What?
I guess I'm just too intimidating for most guys, but no one ever gets close to me. But talk to me and me. We aren't like that.
You're talking to me!
As rebels, we all share the same goals, the same ideals. We have a special relationship that can overcome any obstacles. So what's the request again? Jesus, woman, I just asked what's a good present to get a girl! I spent the present for a girl. It came to the right place. I happen to be an expert on America.
Because you're a girl yourself.
When it comes to presents for girls, you can't go wrong with accessories. Accessories! Girls eat, sleep, and breathe accessories. They're a little pricey, but what about a necklace from Vivian's?
Let's discuss it back at the office.
I think anything over $1,000 would hurt a high school student's wallet a bit much.
Yeah, the price is one thing, but honestly, I'd rather make getting her something girly.
I think it would actually be better to give her something romantic, a present that shows that I put some thought into it. A romantic present. I know I've said I wouldn't ask too many questions, but I have one for you now.
What are you talking about?
You know, she's just getting out of the hospital. Why are you so concerned with her, of getting her such an amazing present? This is a chance for me to tell Sakura, to tell her how I feel.
Shouldn't be Ryo saying this and not talking.
Damn! Tell her how you feel. And what exactly would that mean?
I mean, you know, then I love her.
Love. You like this Sakura girl? Well, of course I do! Why else would I want to tell her how I feel?
I see, but why do you like her?
Well, I don't know.
I guess I just can't leave her, and I want to be with her.
I'm the only one who can protect Sakura!
Oh, I'm the only one who can protect you, Sakura. I'm the only one who can protect you, Sakura. I'm the only one who can protect you, Sakura.
Wait, hey, stop that! Don't say that! Stop it!
Enough already. That's it. Now
do what I hired you to do.
What is it? He really is a self-conscious teenage boy. Please, Masked. We should definitely keep up. Well then. Romantic presents. I think you need to go looking for a romantic friend of yours and ask their opinion about this. What do you think? So romantic friend. Well, I think she is more passionate than one would expect, but she's not the romantic type.
That still goes a long way. How about Anata?
Exactly. You wouldn't think so, but I'd say he's quite the romantic. I think he's an Akimahara.
Or Akihabara.
Do you ask him about a romantic presence?
I forgot it.
I wonder what kind of dream it was.
Akiba!
Got a question for me. Then why are you being so formal for?
What do you know about a romantic present?
Huh? You're looking for a romantic present for a girl.
Romantic!
That's kind of old-fashioned, don't you think? Anyway, why are you specifically asking me this?
I'm a romantic. What are you talking about?
What? You're here at Kyoko's?
Yes.
I can't think of why she would say such a thing. Romantic is...
That's it!
What's it?
How about something like poison and a dagger? What the fuck? Dude!
What's with the face? It would be such a romantic present.
You know, like Romeo and Juliet. You've heard of them, right?
I know about them, but... It's one of Shakespeare's tragedies. It's about the forbidden love of Romeo and Juliet. Romeo thinks that this Juliet has died, so he drinks poison and kills himself. But... Juliet is actually alive, and when she sees that Romeo's dead, she takes a dagger and sticks it in her own heart. So what do you think, romantic, right? Well, I don't know. There's just something touching about such a profound and romantic gesture.
It's a romantic present, and that's that!
You're really dark, dude.
Just a joke! You don't want to label me a weirdo. I was just getting back at you.
A romantic present. How about a ticket to a theme park? Have you never heard that memories are better than possessions? Ride the park, see the parade, kiss underneath the stars. Girls, all that kind of stuff, right? I'll discuss it back with you. Kissing under the stars, just as I thought, is quite dramatic. What do you think? Should they enjoy a daytime theme park? I feel like going on a date should be the next step. First, I'd like to get a present that really grabs her.
You sure do have a lot of conditions.
I know, right? So I've been thinking that I'd rather the present one be too unusual. Something simple but elegant. Actually, you have a point there.
But simple but elegant is a bit ambiguous.
Okay then. I've gotta go to my job. Please go on, I'll speak with you later.
It's the third time he's done that.
I guess I should be used to it by now. But I don't get why he keeps leaving us to do all the work.
So something simple but elegant.
She's not simple. But there's only one friend of yours who I think who can give you that kind of advice.
Yeah, it looks like she's at commissary right now. Please go and ask her about something simple but elegant. I should be able to tell you something.
Simple is good. Simple is always good.
Something simple and delicious, or...
When you walk away, you don't hear me say, please, baby, don't go.
Oh, sorry. Simple and elegant. What do you mean exactly? Please explain in a bit more detail.
Well, you see, a friend of mine, he's, he wants to get something.
Present for someone that's been picked out by someone who doesn't know me.
Uh-huh.
A gift giver needs to think about what the recipient might like. What might make her happy. Think seriously. Think seriously. Consider it. Ponder it. Mull it over. And then choose the best possible present.
JG Mall. Life hacks.
That's what giving a present is all about. It's not what you get. It's the time and energy spent. Only present to think as carefully as he can about the present he wants to give the present to give the gift to him.
Thanks. What about you?
What would make me happy? That's the question. Onigiri.
Onigiri?
That's what I want. Onigiri. She
said that the time spent thinking about the best possible present was the true gift.
Well, of course! That's it! That's exactly what I should do!
I'll think about it, seriously, and on my own. I'll think about what would make Sakura happiest. Okay, thanks, Takumi and Kyoko. Woohoo!
Exactly.
Does he really need to go out running and shouting like that? And where the hell is he going anyway?
Excuse me.
If it's wasted on the young.
I suppose that's a win?
I'm curious to see how this budding romance turns out in the end. I wish him the best of luck out there in Kordinger.
Elsewhere, we get to Chapter 10, to the Promised Land.
Zaxxon, Kuro, Eden にある全てのハッカーに問う。君たちは自由か。何者にも侵されず、何者にも干渉されず、何者にも監視されない。そんな自由が今のエデンに存在するか。エデンの前身である、我々ハッカーの発祥の地でもある聖地アンダーゼロ。そこはこの電脳世界の創造主が理想とした空間であり、今よりもはるかに自由で解放された生活があったという。しかしそのアンダーゼロはエデン発足と同時に接収されて、情報制御を司る無人のサーバーとなり、今では世界最高レベルのセキュリティが施された、単なる要害となってしまった。アンダーゼロは、我々の理想郷はエデン最古のサーバー、バルハラサーバーの中にある。我々ハッカーの手で我々の理想郷を取り戻すんだ。この監視と干渉に満ちた欺瞞だらけの自由を打破するために、我々ザクソンは今より聖地アンダーゼロの奪還を宣言する。志を同じくする者がいるならば、目指せアンダーゼロを。
うまいことやらはりましたな。熱の入った演説、なかなかのもんでしたわ。将来は立派な社長さんどうすな。
Sure like to be in his lap right now.
エデンを守るためなら愚にもつかない伝説だって利用する。どうけも喜んで演じてみせよう。
So you go here wants to be sure assable, the red comp.
僕がアンダーゼロへ到達しさえすれば、何もかもやり直せる。創設者が望んだ理想のエデンを僕の手で再現するんだ。
夕ご飯の願い、きっと叶いますよ。バッチはどこまでもお供しまひょ。
By Yugo's speech, the hackers began to make their way to Under Zero, their holy land.
let's rewind things a bit. You know what? I'm actually going to break this into two parts. So just in case, if I'm running low on time, we won't be running low on time. So in the next part, we'll continue this part. Right after this.